In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to use the Shader Style Presets tool in Flair for Maya to load up or save our own global attributes, quickly changing the shader style affecting the entire image. I'm Henriette from Artineering, and we develop artist-driven tools for stylized rendering. Let's preset some styles. In the previous tutorial series overview, we quickly went over all the different levels of control to art direct things within Flair. Now it's time to get into the details and learn how it all actually works. The highest level of control is provided by the shader style presets, which can be opened by clicking on the style icon in the Flair shelf. The style presets tool is divided into two sections, the saving section at the top and the loading section at the bottom. Sounds simple enough, but what is a style preset? A style preset is a collection of different global values that define the style. These values are provided by the Flair Globals node, which we will cover in the next tutorial. So whenever we select and load a preset or double-click on different presets, all the global values that each preset contains are set within the scene, changing the entire style. This way, you can quickly select a base look to work on. When loading presets, you have options to specify if the world scale, quality, attributes, or canvases should be set. This allows to, for example, keep any canvases you have, but change all other attributes. If you have a lot of style presets, make sure to take advantage of filtering, which only shows presets that contain whatever you write in its name. For example, we've prepared some watercolor presets with WC underscore. Additionally, you can also use the combo box next to it to filter directly by style. If you dig presets, give us a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel with a bell icon to be notified about future tutorials. Back to presetting. Each preset can be edited or renamed. This can be done by right-clicking on them. Edit preset will open up the default text editor with the contents of the preset. Presets are plain JSON files containing the Flair global attribute names and their values. There's no obscure magic to them. Renaming presets will open a small rename dialog to quickly change the name. If you don't like some presets, you can delete them. To do so, select the undesired preset and click on Delete. A confirmation dialog will appear, as deleting a preset cannot be undone. Click on Yes to purge the code, or No in case you decide to give it a second chance. What about saving presets? Saving presets is super simple. Just enter the name of your preset and either press Enter or click on Save. Keep in mind that if the new preset has the same name as the existing preset, the old preset will be overwritten by the new one. Voila! Now you have your own named preset with whatever global values you have previously set. This wraps up the first tutorial, where we learned everything there is to working with style presets. From quickly loading different styles with different options to achieve a base look, to saving them with the click of a button. Everything we have covered can also be found in written form in the documentation, linked in the description below. Presets automatically assign various global style values into Flair. Now it's time to learn all about these global values and dig deeper into art direction by learning how to modify and control them. If you love what we're doing, make sure to purchase a commercial license or become our Patreon to use Flair without resolution limitations and have your name appear in this beautiful list of credits. Thanks for watching, and let's global things up in the next one.